أولا أود أن أشكر كل الفنانين المشاركين. حصل البرنامج على نجاح، الفيورشيب للحلقات وصلت إلى عدة ملايين من المشاهدين حول العالم. What made you come up with this program? So the idea was that so that we don't disconnect, you know, the dialogue that happens between art and community. ADNAF decided that we have to do something that will continue this dialogue, taking the conversation to the internet through these five short episodes.
I have a question.
You're an artist. You're not allowed to ask a question. You have all the answers.
I have a question. Between all the questions that we had to answer, was there one question that bothered any of you? Or like, was like, do I really have to answer this question? Any of the questions?
For me, the question, normally when we're asked, we're sent questions, they're so, you know, dreary, they're expected. These were ones that actually made me think, rethink things I was doing. And so I'm the opposite. I actually found the questions good. They made me rethink about patronage. They made me rethink about working and using Zoom, connecting. I found the questions very interesting. But then from Jalal, what else would I expect?
I have a question for Azza. So the question comes in and says, what made you want to participate in the series?
Thank you. Thank you for the question. Well, I can't say no to Jalal to start with, and an invitation from ADMA, an organization that has supported us for so many years, if not even more than a decade. It would always be a pleasure for me to be part of such a debate and open talk that is done in a way that suits the current situation.
Okay, and I have a question for Abid. Is there anything positive that came out of the coronavirus situation?
With corona the past year, I mean, on a personal note, alhamdulillah, last year I was, despite all the challenges, I was still able to get married. So that's one's big plus. And I'm very happy and lucky for it, you know. I'm still, alhamdulillah, still practicing. I'm very happy to say that I'm still practicing full time. And I'm, you know, just trying to be out there and practice even more.
ما تأثرت وايد لأن عندي مشاريع داخلية يعني اللي داخل مخي أصلاً. فالكوفيد هو مو بزنس أصلاً يعني نحن نشتغل في شيء وسكروه علينا. أنا لازلت منتج في هذا الوقت يعني وما عندي ما عارضني الكوفيد أبداً لأنه هي عبارة عن جائحة ومثل المواسم مثلاً صيف وشتاء وغيره وغيره.
كيف أثرت الجائحة على المشاركات الفنية؟
صح إن كوفيد له يعني أثر، بس إذا كان الفنان هو متعود على العمل والمثابرة أعتقد إن كل الموجودين نفس الظروف يعني عاشوا فيها وما زالوا إنهم متعودين على العمل الدؤوب سواء موجود كوفيد أو غيره. واعتقد حضرتك استاذ جلال يعني بالذات بالرغم انك انت كنت تمر بايام عصيبه جدا وكنت مسوي عمليه بس ما هذا كله ما اثناك عن انك انت تقوم باعمال يمكن اذا حد شافه بقول لك انت ما حد يصدق انه حتى في الوزن وفي التقنيه استخدمت الحديد واستخدمت الخشب واستخدمت يعني ما خليت خامة في على وجه الأرض ما يبيتها في العمل.
How did COVID-19 influence your newer works visually?
So I was able to really experiment in the studio and do things that I would never have the time to do. And so this enabled me to create a whole new body of work. And I'm not sure I would have ever gotten to this work but for the pandemic, because I had that, you know, 4 or 5 months in the studio with no one to bother me. I mean, I'm working out of the university, so even I'm sharing a space with students. And because there was no students, just little things that I didn't have to tidy up every night,
فترة يعني إنتاج بالنسبة لي أنا كفنانة إنه أسوي شيء اللي يريحني وبنفس الوقت يعطيني حرية إنه أرسم بدون ارتباط بأي معرض أو بأي مناسبة.
How has the pandemic changed the nature of your work thematically? What do you want to express now that you didn't have a desire to express before?
I wasn't able to create anything that I wanted, you know, freely. Whatever you see that I've been posting on my social media account, especially specifically Instagram, everything you see there was a commercial artwork, something that was commissioned. So I've been so busy from the beginning of the pandemic until today that I didn't really have a chance to create anything that I really wanted to create. So
for me personally, I had both opportunities, exhibiting in different locations such as Yas Mall. It was an amazing opportunity by the end of December. And the other one was exhibiting online for Art Abu Dhabi for two projects, one with the Special Olympics and one with the Red Crescent Al Ghadir project with the handicrafts. I loved both of them. I loved both experiences. To me, connecting to people is important, but that was very difficult during COVID. And connecting online was a wonderful way to meet new audience and to open dialogue and you know, keep it going and keep it alive. I think personally for me, I definitely have done more work and contribution with the community than I've ever done before. So,
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
What advice do you have for the young students who are thriving to be artists?
When you're in the beginning of your artist career, I think you should take as many opportunities to be part of group exhibitions as possible, whether they are online, whether they are real, actual exhibitions. I think this is something that you're supposed to do. One piece of art is not enough. You need to be working day and night. You have to have at least 20 or 30 artworks available at all times so that you are always ready. Okay,
being a new artist, I was actually wondering if we can actually, you know, I stay in Dubai and I mostly practice live drawings, portraits or still life. I was just wondering, you know, is there a way wherein to grow artistically we can meet, or you guys do any workshop? Or I was curious about that.
Answer this, Sumaya, you want to answer this?
What you can do is just keep producing work. Keep posting them on your social media account. Put the right hashtags so the right people can see your work. If you see an open call there, apply for it. If you think that exhibition or the concept of that exhibition suits you, or if you have works that suit that kind of exhibition, that's how you create the network.
Okay, hello. So I wanted to ask, so I know Michael Rice as a professor, and I wanted to ask how he coped with the COVID and teaching art online.
It was a challenge, but I think it was much better than I anticipated. We in the university before the pandemic, we talked about online classes, not very seriously, quite often. And then all overnight, we were all online. And I think it worked much better than anyone anticipated. Again, prior to the pandemic, we were kind of thinking, oh, this can never work. This won't be very good. And whilst it's certainly not optimal, it is fantastic that we have this resource at this time, and I think everyone is benefiting from it.
How can we think about to call the online exhibitions to galleries, etc., as a threat, or as an opportunity, or I mean, like as a threat to the normality that we used to live, and to the let's say. The relationships that we had, like we are hugging each other. You know, I'm Greek. I'm an owner, so you can understand that I was hugging every single person on earth. Of all.
بالنسبة للمعارض يعني المعارض طبعا العادية افتقدناها. إن الفنان لما يكون في المعرض الحي يتعايش مع العمل بإحساس يختلف ويتعايش مع الجمهور. في هالفترة ما وقفت المعارض، يعني جميع المعارض افتراضية، بس كان في تجاوب وفي يمكن تواصل كبير بين الفنانين وبين بعضهم البعض وحتى بين الجمهور، يعني حتى في هالوقت اللي احنا جالسين فيه في هالساعة يعني نشوف انه في تجاوب وفي أسئلة وفي يمكن ناس حابة تعرف يعني هادول شو قاعدين يسوون أو شو يقولون، فهذا شيء جميل، يعني هذا شيء صحي.
Did COVID affect their accessibility to resources of materials? Like, was it hard to get the materials in, like with shipments and stuff?
Well, okay. Like Michael said, it gave me time to be in the studio with no thing else. So I went through materials really fast. And also with the restrictions of my age, I could only go like once a week to a supermarket. So all the shops were closed. But in fact, you take it to a positive. And I started using paper that you can get in supermarkets that I never would have thought of using. In fact, paper doilies that I don't really even like, but they were the only paper. So from the negative, you find, oh, maybe I could rethink and redo something. So we have to be resourceful all the time as artists and make use of what turns up. So you can't just say, that's all I do. You have to rethink, what can I do with what's available?
Hello.
Hello, everyone. Hi from Brooklyn. I wanted to ask if anyone is shifting mediums, be it from physical mediums to maybe digital or just experimenting with new mediums.
I am a ceramicist, so I work exclusively with clay. So I have shifted in terms of temperature. I'm now firing to stoneware, which is a higher temperature. Because my work has changed and I'm using a material called paper clay. This was all because of the pandemic. As I mentioned, I got the chance to experiment. And so I've been using this new material and new temperature. So it's a subtle change, but to answer your question, broadly speaking, yes, I have moved in that direction. And I can see myself now getting more into the finer points of that. I won't bore you all with all the ceramic technicalities, but I'm working again with porcelain and bone china, so it's an exciting time for me.
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum salam.
فهل في نصيحة ممكن تساعدوني فيها؟ إنه أنا ما أقدر يعني عامل نفسي أنا يتحكم فيني بالرسم بالعادة، فما أعرف هالشي هذا اللي متى راح يدوم.
نعم، بخصوص اللي ذكرته الأخت، أنا مريت في نفس الحالة. فلجأت لللوحة القصيرة اللي ما تخليني أمل بسرعة وأنجزها يعني خلال 10 دقائق.
إذا ما عندك مزاج إنك ترسمين لا ترسمين، بس let it go، اطلعي امشي، حطي لك موفي whatever، أي شيء تبين تسوينه سويه، لا تغصبين عمرك، لأن إذا غصبتي عمرك العمل ما بيطلع، ما منه فايدة، وإذا طلع بيطلع بشكل انت مش عايبنك.
Great. I would love to be really kind, but I have no idea about the mood. I don't wait for inspiration. Work inspires work. Mood, Halliwelli, I haven't time for moods. You must work. The more you work, the more work comes, the more you're inspired. If you sit and wait for the mood, we're not in the 17th century waiting for inspiration. Work and the mood comes. It really does, and there's nothing like work to actually change your viewpoint and get you going. I haven't got, God, look at me. Do I look like I've got time to wait for the mood? Everybody here works, we work through our problems. Everybody here works through our problems.
يوم سألت الأخت عذبة حسيت فيها صراحة، يعني لأن أنا في الفترة الأخيرة دخلت هالجو إن عندي وايد شغل وغيره وشي، بس مو بقادر أمشي قدام، مو بقادر أتحرك. فبكل اختصار اللي سويته حطيت لنفسي وقت بسيط، يعني يومين حتى نص ساعة. فهالنص ساعة أترك كل شيء وأمسك اللوحة وأرسم. اكتشفت مع الوقت اللوحة هي بدأت اللي تسوي، يعني تشدني إني أكملها، لأني أشوف فيه بروجرس قاعد يصير. فأحياناً المود ممكن ينخلق من الحركة هاي حتى لو بجزء بوقت بسيط وقصير.
المحترف أصلاً ما يعرف هذا الجانب أبداً، هذا الهاوي اللي يتكلم بهالطريقة. المحترف هو يعني أرقى مراتب الفنانين أصلاً، يعني يعرف نفسه بالضبط متى يرسم متى يتحرك متى المزاج ما يدخل عنده، لأنه هو صاحب مشروع والمشروع متكامل. أنا ما أجاوب كذي بس إن إحنا نبحث في أدواتنا. الاحتراف هو وسيلة رئيسية اللي تخليك أنت تعرف متى تدخل يا لوحة ومتى تصبر، ما تخلي يعني شيء يسمونه شيء.
السلام عليكم. Hello everyone. I was asked to conclude Art Amid COVID with a few words. Art Amid COVID presents inspiring stories of artist resilience during extraordinary time of uncertainty. Each story tells of remarkable creative spirits who simply refuse to be silenced. They revealed the will to create, to connect, to be seen and heard no matter what. Their dreams inspired us all. The Art Amid COVID series has reached many, many artists throughout the world, and their stories should also be heard. And so the conversation must continue. Thank you.